Good morning to you, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure and privilege continuing the topic of pragmatic leadership with you. I'm sure that you have been regularly going through the various sessions which have been serially numbered. As I mentioned in the previous sessions, the very purpose of sharing these thoughts with you is to give you some kind of easy way of reading my book. I know many people feel that they don't have time to read books, so it will become very handy to go through every small tidbits of some of the thoughts I was sharing in my book, in the videos that I was so far discussing. One of the most interesting aspects I was trying to figure out during the course of my study of the various leaders is they are very keen to go beyond the boundaries which I mentioned in my previous session. That means they were not fixing any particular territory for themselves and they want to play something beyond their territory. Many of you must have read the book Stephen Covey's 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. You may remember that he is talking about one interesting aspect, which is the circle of influence and circle of concern and circle of no concern. So it's very important to recall what he has said, which is one of the most profound way of explaining some of this aspect. Circle of concern, essentially, as I mentioned in my previous session, that all of us very much concerned about our health and our family's health and our own family's welfare and so on and so forth. So a circle of concern is something when something happens or something threatens us within the boundary, that becomes a circle of concern. Meaning if our health is getting affected or our children's health is getting affected, we are concerned about it. But whereas our neighbor's health is affected, we are not really concerned about it. That means this idea of concern coming from within what boundary we want to play our life. So most of the common human beings always have a very small circle drawn within their boundary and then they would like to play within that circle. And we call that as a circle of concern. But some people have decided to play outside their circle of concern, meaning that they want to go beyond and then influence something outside their boundary. That means some people wanted to do some social work, or somebody wants to become the secretary of the society and then they want to look into their own ambience. Maybe it's also a circle of concern in the sense that it is again an extension of your living space that you want to. But nevertheless, it is going beyond the circle of concern. And Stephen Covey calls it this as a circle of influence. That means a circle of influence is something within the beyond the boundary where you can really play to influence the changes that can happen in those environments. So why are we discussing in the context of pragmatic leadership is many people who have drawn a very small circle of boundary and then they said that play within their job description or they within their functional boundary and responsibility. So whenever that we are drawing the boundary and trying to play within that, that means we have mentally decided that's our circle of concern. Anything happening beyond that is not our circle of concern. So that's a circle of no concern. But the people who have gone beyond and then wanted to make a significance in their life for the general public, they really grow beyond leaps and bounds in terms of fame and prosperity or power or whatever you call it. So it is extremely important to understand that when one chooses to work within the circle of concern, they don't grow beyond certain levels. What has this got anything to do with the context of our career is, so organization is a kind of a constellation of people, summation of a system, and it has got its own culture. So when the organization has to exist, that means everyone within the organization has to keep in mind where the direction, what is the direction in which the organization is going, and how the individual's role and going beyond their circle of concern or boundaries and play in a larger space ultimately decides their kind of a growth. So it's extremely important to understand that when we are trying to go beyond our boundaries and tries to understand the larger picture, what is so called the big picture, which I will talk about it in the future sessions. So when we are getting a bigger picture of the entire environment or ecosystem in which we are working, then we start playing beyond our boundaries, and thereby we have a vision to achieve something far beyond our limited vision of selfishness. So one strange thing I found, when you are trying to chase something much more loftier than your personal selfish reasons, the whole world conspires to come along with you and then support you in terms of you know, those kind of a mission that you would like to undertake. I can give several examples from the various Indian Vedic seers or anyone else who have really led the social transformations. Just to take an example of Jesus, when he was during his human form of 37 years, he had only 500 people coming along with him and listening to his sermon. But today the 2/3 of the world's population is following what Jesus said 2000 years ago. So what is most important is, when you are trying to go beyond your boundary, then you will find the whole universe tries to join with you, to help you, support you, they become volunteers and so on and so forth. When Sadhguru declared that he want to plant millions of trees, people came from nowhere and taken up this mission to support him in getting this done. Maybe as 2 million people following him. It's all beyond, you know, when somebody is going beyond their selfish boundary and want to make a difference to the mankind, you will find a lot of people coming forward to help you. I just recall what Deepak Chopra said in one of his lectures, is that every human being is an element of this whole cosmos. Whether we realize it or not, we don't realize that we are an integral part of this whole creation. So that means whatever the creator can create, the same thing can be created by every human being. Someone created the airplane and somebody created the motor car, somebody created the smartphone and so on and so forth. So that means the human beings have got the vast capability to create anything they want. But when you realize that you can be a part of the creation and hence you are a creator, and then you have a vision to do something beyond your selfish boundary, then you will find suddenly a lot of people coming forward to give a helping hand. So Deepak Chopra says that, you know, when you are trying to do something far beyond your personal requirement, the whole cosmos conspires to come along with you and create the kind of environment and resources for you, thereby you will be able to achieve your mission. So in summary, what is important to realize to become a pragmatic leadership is to review your boundaries and check out whether you have really a vision forward about the future. If you don't have a clarity of your vision, obviously, that means you have no plan to do anything beyond your mundane day to day life to look after your family. So if you really want to grow in your career, it's very important for you to realize that you will have to break your boundaries and go beyond. Thank you very much for your patient listening. Look forward to many more such concepts from my book and present it to you in as simpler manner as it is possible. God bless you. Take care. Thanks for your time.